Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video, I will cover operation research over for get transportation part I will cover. First some theory I will tell, after that I will solve some problems from get and IIS so that you can understand this topic. Transportation, it's a set of M supply points from which a good is shipped. Supply is M and set of N demand points to which good is shipped. Demand points are N. If total supply equals to total demand, then the problem is said to be balanced transportation problem. Then if total supply exceeds total demand, if supply is greater than demand, then we can balance by creating dummy demand points that has a demand equal to excess supply. Like this, if supply is less than total demand, then we can balance by introducing dummy supply points. For finding basic feasible solution for transportation problems, mainly three methods are there: northwest corner method, NWC. Sometimes in short form also they are writing, and Vogel's approximation method, BAM. Then minimum cost method or least cost method. These three are important. So, first our example is obtain an initial basic feasible solution or IBF to the problem using northwest corner method. Or any method you can use, first I will use northwest corner method. So, this is given. First I will check. This is supply, here this is demand, M and N. So first I will check whether it's balanced or not. So here I will add all available or supply. Total is 250 plus 300 plus 400, you will get 950. And this side requirements or demand you calculate 200 plus 225 plus 275 plus 250, you will get 950. So both are equal. So this is a balanced transportation problem. No need to create any dummy available point or requirement point. It's a balanced transportation problem. So directly you can go for the next steps. So in northwest corner, you have to start from the northwest corner of the matrix. So here northwest corner is this one. So you have to start from here. Then here you check in row it's 250. Then in column it's 200. So minimum is 200. So allocate 200 here. If you allocate 200 here and you minus 250 minus 200, you will get 50 here for the first row. And here all 200 you allocated, so you can cross this one and this one. Already first column is reduced, column 1, column 2, column 3 and column 4, like this, row 1, row 2, row 3. So first column already reduced. So column 2, column 3, this is column 4. And here row 1, row 2, row 3. Here supply is for row 1. Supply is 250 minus 200. Already 200 you allocated here. So now available only 50. So then again northwest corner. Corner is this one, northwest corner. Here you check which one is minimum. Supply and demand. So here minimum is 50. 50 and 225, you have to check which one is minimum. 50 is minimum, so you allocate all 50 here. If you allocate 50 in row 1 corner point, here for row 1, next step you will get 50 minus 50, 0 supply only. So here you can cut this column 3 and column 4, row 1 you can cut. And here 225 minus 50, you will get 175 for column 2. New demand is 175 for column 2. So next one, next step you have to write matrix. Already row 1 you cancelled, so only row 2 and row 3 available, column 2, column 3 and column 4. Here 18, 14, 10, then 24, 13, 10. Then for next step, you have to check for the northwest corner. Already row 1 cancelled and column 1 also cancelled. So new matrix is this one. So here northwest corner is this one. So here you allocate which one is minimum from supply end and your demand. Supply is 300, demand is 175. So 175 full you allocate here. 175, here you will get 0 and here you will get 300 minus 175. 300 minus 175, you will get 125. Then here for this column 2, it's 0 demand, so you can cut this one. Then new matrix, you will get new matrix in column 3. Already column 2 cancelled, so column 3 and column 4 only. So new matrix is here. Then you can allocate the northwest corner. Here is the northwest corner. Allocate the minimum. Supply is 125 and demand is 275. So allocate minimum is 125. You allocate here. So here you will get 0. So you can cross this one. And here 275 minus 125. You will get 150. Then new one. Then new matrix you will get. Already R2 you cancelled all rows, all columns in R2. So new matrix you will get column 3, column 4 and R3. Here you will get this one only. So here you allocate the minimum. 150 is supply. Northwest corner is this one. So here you check which one is minimum. Supply is 400 and demand is 150. So minimum is 150. So 150 you allocate here. 400 minus 150, it's 250. For last one, only this one available. So full 250 you allocate here. So final matrix you will get with all allocations. So in final step you made the allocation. Here you allocated 200. Next one here 50. Then in 18. Allocated 175, here 125, here 150, then next one here you allocated 250, others are not required. Total allocation points you check, this is one, this is first, second, third, fourth, fifth and sixth. Total number of allocation points are 6. So, M is here and N is here. M plus N minus 1, it should equal to your allocation 0.6. So, M is 3, N is 4 minus 1, it's equal to 6. So, you can get, this is the, so your solution is exist or basic feasible solution is correct. Then you have to calculate the total transportation cost. For total transportation cost, you have to multiply 200 into 11 plus here, then 50 into 13, then 175 into 18. Plus 125 into 14, plus 150 into 13, then 250 into 10. That is the total transportation cost. So here it's a non-degenerate and solution is basic one. Then transportation cost you have to calculate. Z equal to 200 into 11. Already this one I told. Where you allocated, there you multiply that one and add the total allocation cells, you will get 12,200 rupees. This is your transportation cost using northwest corner method. If you practice more, then in single matrix also you can solve the problem. Same answer you will get. Thank you friends. Thank you for watching my video. In next videos, I will solve some problems using VAM and least cost method. Thank you friends. Thank you for watching my video. Thank you.